This is high school basketball on Frontier Community Access Television.
All right, so let's send it to the floor and public address announcer Adam Frenier.
All-stars from the eastern and western parts of Hampshire County. And now let's meet the teams for tonight's game. In the green jerseys, the designated visiting team, the East All-Stars. From Athol, number 14, Julia Carey, and number 33, Hope Parker. From Belchertown, number 10, Kayla Henry, number 21, Cara McKenzie. From East Hampton, number 22, Andy Hall, and number 2, Karina Volpe. From Franklin Tech, number 12, Michelle Lay. From Granby, number 4, Kate Sarnacki. From Mahar, number 5, Katie Gilson. Number 12, Jordan Martin. Number 4, Mackenzie Tenney. And number 31, Cassidy Verham. From Smith Academy, number 14, Olivia Cavanaugh. From Ware High School, number 23, Michelle Zawalski. Coaching the East All-Stars, from Granby, Mr. Tom Berg, and from Mahar, Mr. Larry Fisher. And now let's meet the designated home team in the white uniforms, the West All-Stars. From Frontier Regional, the host school, number 2, Helena Diaz, and number 4, Lisa Portier. From Gateway, number 3, Brianna Fellows. From Greenfield, number 23, Molly Duclos. From Mohawk, number 3, Haley Lowell. From Northampton, number 3, Megan McCarthy, and number 21, Lorraine Johansson. From Pioneer, number 12, Brianna Yost. Number 14, Caroline Merkel. And number 10, Jessica Scoble. From Smith Vocational, number 1, Shannon Ryan. And number 12, Stephanie Start. And from South Hadley, number 13, Sophie Gatsunis. And number 24, Marley Medina. Coaching the West All-Stars, from Mohawk, Larissa Miner, and from South Hadley, Paul Dubuque. The officials, Arthur Burke, Robert Haygood, and George Shaheen. Ladies and gentlemen, to honor America, please rise to the singing of our national anthem. Tonight, the Star-Spangled Banner will be performed once again by Kevin Hollister.
Oh, say can you see, by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glared, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
And we have a nice crowd here at Goodnow Gymnasium for tonight's All-Star Games. Again, the girls now, the boys in a bit, right around 7:30 or so. We'll be taking radio timeouts. Usually the coaching staffs do not call a timeout during the games. They let the girls, later on the guys, play, but we'll have our immediate timeouts. And late in the first half, they'll have the awards presentation. The Sportsmanship Award will go to Greenfield High School. Well-deserved. And Gary Stacy will be honored with the Tom Cove Memorial Award. Unfortunately, Gary not here tonight as he continues his battle against cancer.
As well as
but a well-deserved recipient of the Tom Cove Award. We'll have that presentation for you live on the air late in the first half here.
We also want to send our regards to Glennie Mallett, who's recovering from some surgery as well. Glennie
yes.
would ordinarily be a big part of this, having been a ref, I don't know, he's what, like 40 years he's been doing this?
He's some been, yeah, but, 1976 was his first year, yeah. So over 40 years now.
So, I mean, it's just the longevity is crazy, and Glennie would love to be here, but he's battling a health issue, and we certainly have the utmost respect for him. He's been a real force for this organization and as a referee in this valley.
One of the officials tonight is George Shaheen. I just saw Arnie Schmidt over there. He's running the shot clock, and he has one of those big...
The fat head.
Yeah, right. ...of George Shaheen. I didn't notice that until just now. We're going to be talking, hopefully, with members of the IAABO board. They're doing a recruitment right now. They are looking for basketball officials. So if that is something that you've kind of thought about perhaps doing at some point...
Do I have what it takes,
now
Jeff?
Would be the time.
Do I have it? Do I have the ability?
I think you have watched enough basketball in your life.
Yeah, I think
yes.
I'd run up down the floor once, and I'd probably pass out. So these guys have to be in good shape to do this kind of stuff.
The East All-Stars, the visitors in green, as it is St. Patrick's Day, and then the home team in the white. And those are the West All-Stars. So we will have, again, there seems to be a little bit of a holdup, but we are waiting for the start of the game. And we'll get as many of these girls. I see Haley Lowell of Mohawk is out there for the West All-Stars. And Molly Duclos of Greenfield is out there right now. McCarthy. That's Megan McCarthy of Northampton. So we're going to see a lot of girls that we don't usually broadcast here on Bear Country. And the tip, as it were, is control. Boy, there's no defense at all. What's happening here?
The tip, as it were.
And they're just kind of taking shots here, and the ball goes out of bounds. We're going the other way. No defense at all. And now it's going to be the East All-Star. Check that. The West All-Star's back in. And the East girls, they're just...
I am not sure what that was about.
So they'll get... Oh, you know who that was out there. They Ooh. Were... Sarnacki of Granby was out there.
She got the knee injury.
And they got her out there, and everybody just kind of backed off, bringing to mind the old Nikisha Sale story from UConn way back in the day.
Okay.
And now real competitive basketball is underway. And Diaz feeds it over from Frontier over to Haley Lowell on the right side. Molly Duclos from Greenfield High School gets the rebound, and she hits the baseline jumper from the left side. And the West jumps out to a 2-0 lead. East now back on the attack. We'll get as many of these girls in as possible. Mackenzie hits from the left side. Nice jumper there.
She's very tall.
Kara Mackenzie is out of Belchertown. She is 6'3".
Yeah.
Molly Duclos tried to bring it in on her and then said, you know what, I'm going to go the other way, which is probably a good move. Get a top of the key to Lowell. They dump it down low to Diaz, kicks it right side. Three ball put up right side. It is good. And that is your Western Mass Girls Player of the Year, Gatsunis. Sophie from Northampton High. She's the Western Mass Girls Player of the Year. All right, the green team, which is the East, back on the attack. Shot on the left side, that is no good. They get the rebound, batted down. Comes away to Diaz of the home team, home school, the host school, Frontier Regional. Gatsunis has it deep on the left, passes over to McCarthy. McCarthy gets a screen left of the lane, looks to dish it down low, gets it down to Gatsunis. Mackenzie, though, waiting for. Coming along the baseline, and the shot is up and good.
A nice little penetration move on the baseline.
Nice shot there by Megan McCarthy of Northampton High. It is now 7-2 in favor of the West All-Stars. Jumper on the right side is no good. It goes into the corner, recaptured by the East. East, they can't penetrate, though, on that left side. They get it over on the left side finally, and coming through, swooping through, and hitting the runner. Nicely done by Kayla Henry of Belchertown.
Belchertown girls got some nice moves. We have never seen them this year. That's one of the teams we didn't get a chance to cover.
7-4 in favor of the West. They are attacking the basket out on our right. Coming through, Gatsunis kicks it to Haley Lowell for from Mohawk. Loses the handle as she tried to get it into the paint. Long pass down court. A little bit too much on that. It is recaptured on the baseline. They get it back to McKenzie. Her foul line jumper is short, an air ball, and a nice save along the baseline. Shot, though, on the right side was no good. Nice job, however, there, trying to save that ball by Kayla Henry of Belchertown. Haley Lowell has that at the top of the key. Her pass, though, into the lane is batted down. 7-4. In favor of the West. East now back on the attack. Running through on the right side. Going up for the bank shot. That is no good. And that was an attempted shot there.
They called a foul.
A rare foul call. You don't see that too often in these All-Star games. Kayla Henry will check out now for the East All-Stars. Inbounding on the baseline. They're going to try to get it to McKenzie. Instead, they go on the left side. That shot in and out. No good. And that was Julia Carey. And she's from Athol High School. All right, the West now with a 7-4 lead. Losing the handle as Gatsunas lost her footing, actually.
Yeah, but she's able to hang on to it and not travel. That's pretty amazing.
Cut it over to McCarthy. Haley Lowell dumps it down low to Molly Duclos. She had the first points of the game. Her shot, though, is blocked. Kavanaugh had her all lined up, batted that one away. Between the circles, it is Volpe. Angling now to the right, holds there. Bounce pass back to Hall, back to Volpe on the right wing. In the right corner, they try to get it down low. Nice little give and go. Couldn't quite make the connection. Carey from Athol puts up the runner in the paint. That is no good. Rebound comes down to the West. They lead 7-4, down to 15:53 to play. We'll have our first timeout here coming up in a bit. Ball is tipped away, though. Nice defense there by the East. Volpe, little misdirection in the paint, swoops through and hits. Timeout on the floor. 15:41 to play here in the first half. And on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, it is the West All-Stars leading the East 7-4 on Bear Country. All right. The West All-Stars in the white. And they're going to get some Pioneer girls out there. Brianna Yops is out there right now. And she'll be joined by some of her teammates. Jess Scoville is here, and Caroline Merkel is here as well. Brianna Yops just missed a three from the right side. Olivia Kavanaugh from Smith Academy comes away with it. The head of the circle. Verhaen of Mahar gets it down low to one of her teammates, but unable to get the shot away. She got rejected down low. See who came up with that block. Well, that is Medina from South Hadley High School. That shot is no good from the right side. Start from Gateway. Held ball down low. Possession arrow will favor the East All-Stars. They trail by one. And then we'll get the ball. They get it to Kavanaugh. And she is being joined out there. We'll get some of these girls as they go along here. Martin is out there. Kavanaugh, top of the key, nearly dragged that pivot foot, gets it over to Martin, shot clock down to 15. Over to Kavanaugh, trying to get it down low, unable to do so. Now they finally get it to Cassie. Verhaen goes left baseline, in and out, no good. Rebound taken down by the West. Brianna Yopst of Pioneer gets it on the right side. Three ball put up on the right side. That shot is no good by Johansson, and now coming back. And Tenney of Mahar dumps it down low. Martin turns, shoots, banks it home.
Nice little pass move down low.
So Mahar getting involved in the action here, and they have taken a lead now. East All-Stars lead by one. It's 8-7. 13:55 to play here. Brianna Yops drives the paint, went for the bank shot, no good. Loose ball picked up by Kavanaugh of Smith Academy. She takes it into the front court right. They dump it down low. Cassidy Verhaen, nice post move as she hits down low.
That's her move, that little post hook shot.
10-7 now in favor of the East. They trailed early 7-2. They're on an 8-0 run now. Again, you see this a lot in these All-Star games. You get a group of five on the floor that just seem to mesh. They miss again now from the left side. As the Gateway girls start, unable to hit. Martin comes back now for the East All-Stars. Kavanaugh on the right wing, holding it over her head. Gets it back on the right side. DeMartin comes through, gets rejected down low.
Oh, that was a nice play.
They try to get it right back to her. Yops, top of the key. Nearly picked off. Shot up from the left side. That is short. And rebound put back and a held ball. The arrow this time will favor the West All-Stars.
Michelle Zawalski checks into the game for the East.
Zawalski is out of where? Michelle Zawalski. They get it into the top of the key. Feed the paint. They tip it back. Ball loose on the floor. Finally recaptured again. Plenty of time on the shot clock. 21. Start. Zips a pass over. Top of the key. Yops gets the tip ball right side. She'll launch a three. That's a little bit short. An attempted save on the baseline. No good. Out of bounds. It'll go back to the East All-Stars with a three-point lead.
So far, pretty close game. Nobody's running away with it. That's for sure.
The East, though, right now on an 8-0 run. Cassidy Verhand has it. They dump it down low. Top of the key. Zawalski, right side, to Olivia Kavanaugh. Kavanaugh to Zawalski. Into the right corner, out of bounds. They will save it. We will take a timeout right here. 12:22 to play here in the first half. And our score on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, the East All-Stars leading the West 10-7. All right, the play back on, and finally another bucket put up and in by the East All-Stars as they are now on a 10-0 run. They lead by 5, 12-7. Shot by the East, an air ball too strong on the right side. Jess Scoville is out there now from Pioneer, and also Caroline Merkel from Pioneer out there, so a couple of familiar names there. Zawalski from Ware gets over to Cassie Verhand, top of the key. Left side it goes to Tenney. Tenney comes through, pushes it up on the left side, went for the bank, no good. Rebound is pulled down. Here comes McCarthy back for the West, trying to stem the tide here. They try to get it to Merkel in the paint, tipped away. And recaptured now by Michelle Lay from Franklin County Tech, formerly of Turner's Falls High. Zawalski, jumper from 12, no good. Rebound is pulled down by McCarthy. 12-7 in favor of the East right now. They get it in. McCarthy, wraparound pass. Caroline Merkel went for the bank, no good. There is a lid on that bucket right now. Shuffle pass back to Scoville, gets blocked out of bounds. They will keep it. Now a fresh five coming in for the East All-Stars.
Well, this is unusual to see a line change like that in the middle of a possession. Usually they do the line change at the TV timeout, but yep, not that time.
Kayla Henry's out there. Volpe back out there now. Little hook pass. McCarthy from the foul line fakes the shot. Passes on the right side. They get it back to McCarthy again. McCarthy's going to go baseline. Working it all the way around. Gets tipped out of bounds. It's off of the West All-Stars. Back to the East.
Looked like McCarthy had a shot at a reverse layup if she wanted to take it, but she decided to pass.
Again, we will have our awards presentation. Another jumper put up and in from the foul line. We'll see who that was. That was number 33. Well, that's Hope Parker of Athol.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And now the pass picked off down low. We're coming back the other way. Parker, cross-court pass, left side, jumper, up and no good. And some of the girls giggling as they head down court. That was Kayla Henry who missed that one. In a high post, McCarthy. They're just begging for a bucket here. They swing it. On the left side, 18-foot jumper is short. One and done for the West. The East now, a two-on-two break. Over to Kayla Henry, high off the glass and in.
Nice move. Henry was right where she needed to be on that one.
16-7. They're on a 14-0 run. They trailed 7-2. Air ball. They're going to get a new crew out there, I think, for the West All-Stars. That's going to be a travel. Yes, we're going the other way. They're on the break. We have a substitution coming in for the East.
Well, East doing a lot of subbing. You don't usually see this much kind of subbing during a game like this. Suppose they're playing this thing to win?
Yeah, I would say so. Andy Hall of East Hampton just checked in. All right, pass tipped out of bounds, and it's going to stay with the West All-Stars. Trailing now by 9. They get it into Ryan. Ryan at the top of the key, foul line left, stops there, try to get it to McCarthy, tipped away, ends up in the backcourt. McCarthy will pick it up. It was tipped by the East, so no backcourt violation. Caroline Merkel, a line drive shot, no good. And getting up there and getting that rebound.
All she had to do was raise her arms. Basically, she's 6'3", for God's sake.
That's true. First, we're talking another loose ball. This time, it is picked up by the West. Trying to break this run. 14-0 run right now. Merkel gets it to Ryan. Oh, she wanted to pull the trigger. Pass batted down. Here comes Volpe. And she will circle back, look for teammate, fires a pass on the right side. Rainbow J is good.
Well, that was quite an arc. Talking about a rainbow, that was a double rainbow.
Julia Carey from Athol with the bucket there. 18-7 and a 16-0 run. Well, we saw a 32-0 run in the tournament. I thought that the biggest run I'd ever see, but we're halfway there. McCarthy drives through the paint, does not get the roll. Again, a lid on that basket.
Did not fall, but they got the rebound.
So they do keep possession. Ryan, top of the key. She'll launch for three. Good.
Ryan got away with the travel there, I think, but got the three.
Makes it 18-10 in favor of the East with 8.5 to play. We have our next timeout coming up here momentarily. Top of the key. Hall is going to launch a three way high. Almost hit the top of the backboard.
Almost like playing the savings bank across the street on that one. That was playing the bank for real.
And she's grinning as she heads down court. She looked at her family and said, I followed through. And she did.
She did.
Ryan takes a jumper from the right side. A little bit short. Put back up and good by McCarthy. And we'll be taking a timeout right here. We'll take the break. 8:04 to play here in the first half. Competitive first half here in the Girls All-Star Game. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. It's the East 18, the West 12. Again, coming up, I believe it's going to happen at the next timeout, I do believe. They're going to have the awards presentation. Greenfield High School will be honored as the recipient of the Sportsmanship Award. And then the Tom Cove Memorial Award will be going to Gary Stacey.
I do believe there's a certain broadcaster in this game who was a winner of that award at one point. His name escapes me.
A few years ago, right down here at Goodnoe Gymnasium.
That's right. It was right here in this building.
It was right in this building.
That's right.
Olivia Cavanaugh is going to launch a three. That is short. Sophie Gatsoundis coming back from South Hadley. Feeds it down low. Shot up and in. And hitting that shot was Lorraine Joensen of Northampton. They get it down low, a foul. Down low, and Cassie Verhaen's gonna go to the line shooting two.
Well, Cassie Verhaen had a great season. It's unfortunate that Mahar's trip to the cage ended the way it did, but she got into foul trouble early, otherwise that might have been a different game. Still would have been a loss, because Hoosick was just playing out of their minds that
night. Yeah, they were incredible. And
eventual Western Mass champions.
But I will tell you this, that that comeback after that horrible start at Greenfield in the quarterfinal round was amazing.
That's one they'll be talking about for a long time.
No, that was just, and she was obviously a huge part of that big comeback. Haley Lowell gets it down low, and a block down low and a foul, and they thought they had all ball.
That was Cassie that made that block, and I thought it looked like a pretty good block to me. If fans don't like it, well, they aren't happy with it, but it's not like they're there's that huge.
Adam Frenier saying George Shaheen on that bad call.
And, of course, that resulted in the fat head being flashed on the opposite side of the court.
Lorraine Joensen hits the first free throw. She's from Northampton High. That was funny.
You're not likely to see that a ref get called out like that in any other venue but this one, because they're all buddies and they like to bust each other.
Yeah. Even the guys that – what's nice is that even the officials that aren't working will come here. You know, they have a sign-up sheet. You know, some people work a ticket table. There's the recruitment table. They're looking for new refs. We'll have more on that in a minute. We'll try to get some of these guys on the air, by the way, as we go through here in the second half. Zawoski with a nice feed down low, unable to handle it, though, from the Mahar Senators, Kenzie Tenney.
That was a great pass, though. I mean, it was right there.
19-16 in favor of the East. West can tie or at least get to within one. Molly Duclos with the first bucket of the game misses there, and we had a foul this time called by Artie Burke. No, just going to say it's out of bounds.
It'll be in the bonus pretty soon when these guys are calling fouls.
I know.
Let him play. Let him play.
Martin, between the circles, gets it into a high post. They get it left side, shot up, and no good by Michelle Lay. Rebound comes down. Here comes Sophie Gadzunis off the dribble. The leaner banks it home.
What a shot.
And a foul. And one. Says, no, wave it off.
Offensive foul.
Offensive.
Well, Gatsuna's grinning as she goes up the floor.
I don't know. I wouldn't be grinning.
Looked like a good shot to me.
Yeah, it looked really good.
This is the third or fourth time we've questioned the officials in this game. It's the ref's game, too.
Cassie Verhand tried to dump it down low, tipped away, got it back, hit the underside of the backboard. It comes away to the West All-Stars. Haley Lowe, a long pass way over the head of Sophie Gatsunis. And we have a substitution. Olivia Kavanaugh is going to come back in. And Zawalski from Ware will take a seat on the bench.
It's unlikely we ever see a dunk in a girls' game with Kara McKenzie out there for Belchertown, 6'3". We could see that.
That would be
Sarah
awesome.
From alley-oop.
That would be incredible. As someone who can only jam on the kiddie hoop
yes.
at the Y.
I can do it, but I have to have a trampoline.
Yeah, yeah, me too. Another foul down low. See who else we have over here. We got Nate. Nate Burdick's always good to go on the air. He's very well-spoken. He's still part of the board, and he did work down at the cage this past weekend. A jumper for two. Left side is good. No, they're going to say three for Jordan Martin.
That should be two. She was inside the arc,
yeah,
I thought.
I thought, too. But anyway, it's 22-16. On the right side, Haley Lowe, a line drive shot up and no good. A loose ball picked up again by the East. They lead by six, 22-16, as it's been a game of runs so far. On the right side, Michelle Lay, her pass batted down. Bear Country listeners know Michelle. She is a race car driver up at Monadnock.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, she loves that probably more than basketball, maybe more than anything. Michelle gets the rebound right now. Outlet pass on the left. Yep, she used to play at Turner's Falls High, now is part of the tech school. Shot from the left side is no good. Molly Duclos clears the board, being pestered by Michelle Lay. And Michelle nearly came up with the bat down. Haley Lowell from Mohawk on the right side. Passes it down low, and on we have a foul down low.
That's on Varian, I believe, who blocked out Helena Diaz from Frontier.
Michelle Zawalski checks back into the game.
Zawalski from Ware back in for the East All-Stars. West has it right now. Gadzunis down low.
Oh.
Oh, just unable to hit it. The putback, no. Gadzunis goes up strong again. No, but a foul. As Johansson just couldn't quite make the connection.
That was
there.
A really good pass, though. That one should have been 2 points.
Sophie Gadzunis at the line shooting.
We are close to the bonus in one of these teams.
Yeah,
five team fouls.
Yeah, five team fouls on the home team. That was the third team foul. On the East. First free throw by Gatsunis is good. She'll get one more.
It would be ironic if we had foul shots in the bonus in a refs game,
yeah.
Basically, where the refs
usually swallow their whistles.
Yeah, you would think.
And Jordan Martin will check out now as Michelle Lay just came back in. Free throw is up. It is good. 22-17 has got 22-18 rather has got Zunis hit two free throws on the left side. That is Zawalski. Gives it up to Verhand between the circles. Goes over to Michelle Lay, right back to Verhand, and hits it from the left side. Nice give and go there.
He's had enough spin on it to actually make a rebound back in, because it was looked like it was going to go over the basket.
24-18 now in favor of the East. Three-pointer put up from the left side for the home team West. No good. East comes back with Verhand of Mahar all the way through. Dishes on left side. Baseline runner. No good by Zawalski. One and done. Here comes Gatsunis from South Hadley. Kicks it right side off the hands of Diaz of Frontier. Out of bounds. It'll go back to the East. Boys game to follow a little bit later on. And definitely expecting those guys to put on a show. I see Turner's Falls, Tion Brown just got here.
Yeah, for once, Tion and Samiro are going to be on the same team.
That's right. All the way through.
Tion's not going to have a problem with that, I don't think.
Timeout on the floor.
Gadzunas hits, and we are going to take a quick timeout here. This is Bear Country 95.3. Back for more from the All-Star Game right after this. All right, play back on now, and the East with the ball and the lead, and driving through and hitting was Hope Parker from Athol. Nicely done by Hope. Hustles back on defense, shot from the left side, no good. Goes out of bounds, and really the West All-Stars, after getting off to a nice 7-2 start, they have struggled to stay in this one. It's 26-20 right now in favor of the East. They have the ball right now.
Ooh.
Tipped out of bounds, it's going to go right back to the West.
He's kind of airmailed that pass a little bit.
It was caught by Mike Kacheski as it went out of bounds. Mike Kacheski, former baseball and football player at Greenfield High School, Springfield College. He's the current athletic director at Greenfield High School. He's here to accept the trophy, accept the award, the plaque, for the Sportsmanship Award. Greenfield High School will be receiving that later on tonight. Batted down in the paint, coming back quickly. Is the East. Kayla Henry drives through, the little finger roll, good.
Great little move there by Kayla Henry.
28-20 in favor of the East. They went on a 16-0 run earlier. Fellows puts up a jumper from the free throw line, no good. Followed her own shot, couldn't come up with it. Back quickly comes. And shot up and no good by Hope. This ball coming through, all the way through, Jeskoval of Pioneer, a little bit too strong on that one though. Goes to Medina from South Hadley. Her shot is no good. Volpe gets the rebound. We have 2:52 to play here in the half. It's 28-20 in favor of the East. Three-pointer left side up and no good by Henry. And one and done for the East. West comes back quickly. Jess Scoville gets it from her teammate, Brianna Yops. They pass it left side. Jumper from 18. Went for the bank. No good. Loose ball in the paint. Volpe picks it up. And they're going to call her for a travel. Going the other way. And McKenzie will check out. And Carey comes back in. Julia Carey from the Athol Red Raiders. And the inbounds the ball. Little jump hook by Start down low. Ball. We have a held ball. And on the arrow, it'll go back to the East.
They haven't had as many tie-ups as we would have in a conventional girls game in this one. A couple of, but not a lot. A lot of flow in this game.
All right, Henry jogs it across the timeline, head of the circle, zips a pass on the left side. Junk pass, a little shuffle. They go into the right corner now. Shot clock at 18. Pass is picked off. Here comes Start. Pull-up pop from the foul line. Went for the bank, no good. Deep rebound, run down by Brianna Yops. Bree has it. And, ooh, looks like she wanted to take a three. Instead, a three ball put up way off the mark. Here comes Henley. Wow, great speed all the way through. High off the glass. Yes.
Yeah, she does have great speed. Man, she got down that court in about 3 seconds.
Took it coast to coast, and it's a 10-point lead now for the East at 30-20. Minute 45 to play here in the first half of the girls' all-star game. The boys to follow. Start on the left. Cross-court pass over to Yop. She gets tied up. And a foul is going to get called against the East.
I love the reactions on some of these fouls.
Yeah.
It's like, come on, you really going to call a foul on me for that? All I did was grab her by the arm.
That was Andy Hall, who wasn't all that happy with that call. Yops has it on the right side. Looking for her teammate, Scoville. To get over Start from 19. Just a little bit too much on that. She has been off. Rebound is pulled down by Hope Parker. Hope. All the way back on the right side. Now she'll try to go baseline, but couldn't quite make the penetration shot. The pass, though, is batted down. And we have a foul called as they went for the steal. And it's going to go back to the East All-Stars. They lead by 10.
It's going to be on Jess, I think.
A minute eight, yeah, Jess Scoville of
And one
Pioneer.
More, and we're into the one and one.
Being the one and one, which I don't. Okay, do you ever remember
never.
That happening?
It's never happened as long as we've been doing these games.
And we have another blocking foul. They're not supposed to be playing D the way they are. I mean,
you're right. It's 30-20. It's a pretty. It's a defensive struggle. One and one.
I see Bob Betzold over across the way talking with Mike Kacheski. He's working the boys D4 final down at Springfield College tomorrow. Congratulations to him. Free throw is up and good by Kayla Henry. She'll get one more. And Brian Fury is working on Championship Saturday as well. and he's going to be working at Mass Mutual. So two guys from Board 28 will be working state final games tomorrow. Congratulations to them both. Well, the lead now is 12 after those free throws with a minute left here in the half. 32-20 in favor of the East All-Stars. The West has just really slowed to a crawl offensively. Jess Scoville, the putback, no good. Hope Parker gets it back. Long pass too high for Volpe. Here comes Bree Yops. Runs it up on the left. Gets it over to Start. She's going to launch a three. That is good.
Ooh, way outside.
Stephanie Start hits the tray. And the West now back to within nine at 32-23. Down to 30 seconds left. Three Ooh. Ball, though. Carey.
A little showtime.
A little showtime. She did a little three hand gesture. I like that, actually. In this game, you can get away with that. If I see that during the regular season, I probably call her out on the air, but that was kind of cool. All right, Start's going to take another three just off that time. And it goes over to Carey. 5 seconds left in the half. Carey has it. Come on, put it up. Top of the key. Lets it fly at the buzzer. Ooh. Went for the bank. No good. Halftime here at Goodnow Gymnasium in South Deerfield. The girls' all-star game and our score on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. It's the East 35, the West 23. And welcome back to Goodnow Gymnasium, South Deerfield girls' all-star game, and the East leading by a score of 35-23. Chris, some good action in that first half, particularly that great 16-0 run by the East.
Yeah, you don't often see runs like that in a game like this. Usually it's back and forth, ebb and flow, but they definitely got a hot hand going, and we'll see if they can continue that in the second half.
And I think the other thing of note, the fact that the teams actually D'd up for a while there.
They did. Yeah, I mean, that's a pretty low score for first half of an all-star girls game, but you know, there's always a second half to go. We started raining threes there at the very end, and if that starts happening more and more, these numbers are going to start to go up.
Well, we're going to be back with you again as we continue here tonight. We have the boys' all-star game coming up, and then late in the girls' game, we will have the awards presentation, Greenfield High School for the Sportsmanship Award, and then the Tom Cove Memorial Award going to Gary Stacy. We'll talk more about that coming up in a bit. Take another timeout here on the halftime report. We'll come back, get you set for the start of the second half with the East leading the West by 12, 35-23 on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. All right, we are set for the second half here. The West will have the ball. They lead, they trail rather by 12. They got to a 7-2 lead. They endured a 16-0 run against them, but they trail by 12. Nate Burdick, vice president of the IAABO Board 28, is going to join us here as play gets underway in the second half. Nate.
Hey, Jeff, how are you? Yeah, Welcome back.
Yeah, we always have you on the air with us. You're always generous with your time. Appreciate that.
A tradition unlike any other.
That's right. There you go. Jim, we stole that from Jim Nance, obviously. Nate, obviously, I've done this for a long time. I've never seen a bad basketball season. And, ooh, Sophie Gadzunas with a nice little 360.
U.S. Naval Academy is going to enjoy her skills.
Absolutely, absolutely. But let's talk about the recruitment. Looking for some basketball officials. And I'll just throw this out to you. I think a lot of men and women, you know, they may be into basketball. They may think that they may want to do that. But I hear a lot of people say, well, you know what, I watch basketball. I think I know the game. I watch it a lot this month because it's March Madness. Yeah. But, you know, I don't know if I know basketball that well to be an official. They couldn't be more. There's a complete training program.
There is. And it's quite a process, and it's a commitment. And having had people, you know, watch basketball from the stands and then have to go through the experience of choosing to move forward to becoming a basketball official, it's a totally different animal. And this past couple of years, we've had a couple of good classes come through, and it totally changes their perspective of officiating a basketball game and doing it the right way. And invariably, every single one of them have a completely different perspective of, wow, I didn't realize how hard it is when you're actually out there on the spot. And using judgment and mechanics and what be, but it's no one's ever missed a call from the stands.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, so but when you get out there, it's different. It is, and it's tough. It's challenging, but it's also very rewarding because we get a chance to give back to the game that we love.
What is it like when you're out there on the floor, say at the cage in yep. Amherst? You got about 3,000 or 4,000 people, and they're right on top of you.
Sure.
And the pace of the play. You know,
sure.
It just seems like it gets ramped up during the postseason. Nerves are frayed. What's that like? Because you got to lock in and concentrate.
You do, and a lot of it comes down to training, and trusting the training, and yes, the stage gets bigger and brighter the deeper you go into the playoffs, and the arenas get a little bit bigger. But at the same time, the court's still the same size. There's still 10 players, 5 on each team, and you have to trust the skills and the training that you've gone through. And you have to go through and take the good with the bad, and you got to come through it with some scars every now and then, and you learn from it. And every single time I and every single one of my brother and sister officials referee a basketball game, we've never reffed a perfect game, and we always walk away learning something.
37-29 right now in favor of the East, but the West, you know, they got a crew out there that's being spearheaded by the girls' Western Mass Player of the Year, Sophie Gadzunas. They're making a bit of a run. They're now back to within 6. Again, everybody gets to play, but, you know, these coaches, they always tell me that when they come out here, you know, they're, first of all, there's some girls out there that haven't played in 2-3 weeks because their teams weren't part of the postseason, and they're playing with girls they never played before, so it's a coaching challenge.
It is, but at the end of the day, it's an all-star game, it's an exhibition, but when the ball goes up and there's referees out there and you're wearing two different colored jerseys, it's a competition,
yeah.
And everyone wants to win, and these young ladies that are playing, they all love to win.
Oh, a nice feed down low. Michelle Zawoski of Ware just hit, and she got fouled. I was going to ask you, in that first half, we almost went into the bonus. That Chris and I were saying, I don't think we've ever seen that in an all-star game. These girls were actually D'ing up in the first half.
They did. I happened to be walking by the green bench, and Tommy Burke, Coach Tommy Burke, said to me, he goes, 1-1 in an all-star game. I said, hey, these girls want to play. They want to win.
They do. Free throw no good, but it's a 6-point game right now. And now Gadzunas back, dumps it down low, high off the window, no good. And a foul on the rebound. So it's 39-33. So people may want to get involved in officiating high school basketball. What can they do to get the ball rolling, so to speak?
So first and foremost, through the years, we've had a healthy number of basketball officials. And when I say we, I'm not talking about just Franklin and Hampshire County, but really throughout the country. But in the last couple of years, we're now starting to experience a shortage. And it's not just basketball, too. It's baseball umpires, it's softball umpires, it's football referees. And the reality is that there's now a shortage to the point where we are actively recruiting people that want to get involved to officiate. And the best part is that we have an awesome training program. There's a class that you go through in the fall, and we are actively recruiting people. So if you think you can do it and sitting in the stands and you have some time and you want to give back, it's a great way to get involved with student athletes, and we are more than happy to have you help us out. And we hear you from the stands. We do.
Join us down on,
sure,
on the floor.
Sure.
And, you know, you make some very close relationships. When you're out there, oh, we're going to take a media timeout.
Sure.
Could you hang real quick?
Absolutely.
All right, we'll take a timeout. It's now 41-37 in favor of the East, as the West, behind Sophie Gadzunas, they're making a bit of a run. Back after this on Bear Country. Back here at Goodnow Gymnasium, Nate Burdick, the vice president of the board of basketball officials, is joining us here courtside as we have a 41-37 game here in the girls' all-star game. Boys to follow. Nate, I was mentioning, you know, when you do get involved with this, you know, you make some close friends. Hey, George Mendez from Greenfield. You make some close friendships. And you're out, you know, when you're out there, whether it's a two-man crew or a three-man crew, if it's a tournament game or whatever it might be, you know, you have to work together. And, you know, you're out there for an hour and a half or so. You're running up and down the court. You're getting in shape, but you're covering each other, and you end up developing some pretty pretty tight relationships.
I can honestly say some of my closest friends are my fellow brother and sister basketball officials that I work with. And the relationships that you form are just unbelievable. And just really a good group of people who are out here doing the right thing and trying to give back to our communities in any which way we can. And it's a long season. It really is. And we're away from our families, and it's tough being away. And we have to have spouses. And I have a fiance who's very supportive of what I do. And without her support and all of our everyone else, and when their spouses support, we just can't do it. So it's without it, and we're very, very thankful. And we just want to continue to help grow the game.
And, Nate, before I let you go, I want to talk about two guys who have been basketball officials for so long And neither one of them are here tonight. One of them will be honored here shortly. But we'll talk about Glenn Mallett. 1976.
Yes.
When he started officiating. He's in his 60s now. He's the youngest 60-something guy I know. And I know that he had surgery a while back, but you can't keep a good man down, right?
Nope, and I talked to Glenn not too long ago, and his spirits are up. He's doing great. He's on his way to a full recovery.
Awesome.
And he is just itching to get back next year, and I know for a fact that he missed every single part of not being able to be on the court for the full season. He was able to do about half a season, but he'll be back with us next year, and he can't wait.
Bucket by McCarthy of the West, but wave it off as she took an extra step in the lane. A little bit later on, near the end of the girls' all-star game, a great guy, Gary Stacy, is going to be honored by your board here. He's going to get the Tom Cove Award, which is huge.
Yes, and Jeff, as a past recipient of the Tom Cove Award, I think you understand what this award means and what it stands for. And Gary has been a basketball official on our board for coming up on 30 years, and he's had some recent health challenges, and he's fighting like heck. And we were hoping he was going to be able to be here with us tonight, but unfortunately his current health didn't allow, so his family members are going to be here to accept on his behalf, and we're going to do that in about 15 or 20 minutes. And Gary and Tom Cove had a real impact on Gary's early officiating career, and Gary, if he was here tonight, I'm very confident would say that Tom Cove was a mentor to him, and that's really what this whole hobby or avocation is about, the mentoring program that goes on, and every single successful basketball official can point to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mentors that really showed him or her the ropes coming up, and we owe everything to our mentors, and it's just a great, great line.
Yep, I'm looking forward to that, and of course, obviously, we wish all the best to Gary. Again, having a tough time, but he's putting up the strong fight, obviously. Nate Burdick, thank you so much for taking the time.
Jeff, thanks for having me on.
All right, you bet. Thanks for having us here again.
Good luck the rest of the night.
All righty.
Thanks for your support, too.
And we have a really good game going on right now, 45-44 in favor of the home team, the West. They got a big burst from Sophie Gadzunas out there, and now this particular crew, they got Helena Diaz of the home team, the host school, Frontier, just hit a bucket, and Molly Duclos is giving them a nice lift as well. But a deep three-point bomb put up by the East is no good, and now again, great run here in the second half. Portier, Lisa Portier of the home team Frontier, her pass gets tipped out of bounds. And Lisa will throw in right in front of her own bench. 12:22 to play. We have another media timeout coming up. But back and forth we go. Very tightly contested girls' all-star game. Portier, McCarthy tipped away. Loose ball on the floor. And unable to save it. It'll stay with the West.
Well, you could see it at the half. I was watching Larissa Miner from Mohawk, and she was definitely going over her team looking for the best possible combinations.
Timeout on the floor, 12:13 to play in the basketball game. And on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, West over the East right now by 1 point, 45-44. All right, play back on now. Ryan of the West All-Stars gets it to her teammate Start, Haley Lowell. Cross-court pass, McCarthy holds there. And jumper three ball, top of the key, that's an air ball out of bounds. It will go back to the East.
Right line, just not enough juice behind that shot. Otherwise, it would have been a three.
Always nice to speak with Nate Burdick. This year, he is serving as vice president of the board. He works a lot of college games now, and he is a top-shelf guy. He's one of the nicest people. Yep. A very impressive young man. Graduate of Greenfield High School, played for Bill Beauregard, great golfer. And played baseball at GHS as well. Ball down low and unable to hit was Zawalski of Ware High School for the East All-Stars. Tipped out of bounds. The East will keep it. And I don't know what Nate's, what his desires are, his goals as a basketball official, but he's working a lot of college games now. I guess there might come a time when he's not part of the board anymore, but hopefully, again, he was trying to get some new membership in there. And hopefully we'll get some new basketball officials out there because they have a great time doing it. Start puts up a three, left side no good. Lowell, the weak side rebound, stripped on the way up. Cassie Verhan and Michelle Lay tries to save it, couldn't quite do it.
some of these guys aren't getting any younger. I mean, that's the reality. And
mm-hmm.
you don't see also a lot of female referees. I think that they'd like to have some women get involved, I would think.
Absolutely, yeah. And they do make very good officials, obviously. Shot rejected down low. Cassie Verhand.
Well, the one I think of is Alan Hastings.
Yes.
The wife of David Hastings. She's refed a few games I've seen, and she does a really good job.
Martin dips it down low, and Michelle Lay, no, put back high off the window, no good. Rebound pulled down by the West. They lead by one, 45-44, 10:30 to play in the basketball game. Deep shot left side, no good. Put back the bank, no good by Starr. Tipped out of bounds. It goes back to the East.
Good crowd coming in. I mean, this is going to be a capacity crowd by the time we're done. Lots of people filing in.
Yeah, you're right, Chris. I didn't really take note of that. Not quite a full house, but getting pretty close. Several hundred people here. Now a nice steal. Start coast to coast. She'll lay it up and in.
Well, and could we be flirting with overtime here? I don't know. 10 minutes left. Pretty close game.
West with a three-point lead, 45-44. Shot up and no good by Zawalski. One and done, tipped out of bounds. It'll go back to the West. 10 minutes to play. And again, our presentation coming up, I believe, at the 4 or 5 minute mark.
You know you want to say in regulation. You know you want to say it.
I know, because as you said, OT is a very definite possibility. Start bounce pass. Haley Lowell, top of the key here. Pass batted down. Loose ball picked up. Here comes Cassie Verhand. All the way through left side, left to lay in. Rejected down low, out of bounds. The East will keep it. Michelle Lay back in for Martin. Get that out of there, she said.
Yeah, I was going to say.
That's Marley Medina from the South Hadley Tigers. They bank it in from the left side. Kenzie Tenney of Mahar. South Hadley unable to get it done against Hoosick in the Western Mass Final.
Well, that was a pretty close game, though. You saw some of it. I mean,
they
got beat, but they didn't get beat by much.
Not by much. They were right with them most of the way. All right, 47-46 in favor of the West. East can reclaim the lead right here. Coming through, Kenzie Tenney, and a blocking foul against Ryan. And that is five team fouls now against the West. No fouls on the team for the East so far here in the second half. Coming through, a little scoop shot up by Kenzie Tenney. No good. She has two free throws coming off to our right-hand side here.
Well, Kenzie Tenney. As we mentioned, Mahar didn't end the way they wanted it to in the cage, but they'll always have that Greenfield game to look back on. And a really 13 wins in a row, I think, to finish the season.
That's right, yeah.
Pretty amazing.
Yeah, they got hot at the right time, no question. Looking forward to some of these male players that we're going to see one more time here on the Boys All-Star game. We'll talk more about that on the pregame. But one guy I'm eager to see is Colin Gould. Generally do maybe one Franklin Tech game a year. He's the county's leading scorer this year. He had a huge season, 1,000-point scoring. We're going to see Colin out here one more time. Pass is picked off by Kavanaugh. Olivia runs it up on the right. Bounce pass. And coming through, Zawalski got blocked. She will go to the line. And she's going to shoot two. 47-47 tie. We have another media timeout coming up here momentarily. First free throw is no good. And Martin checks in for the East. One more for Zawalski. Sights it, shoots it, and in and out, no good. Battle for the rebound, and it comes down to Start. She runs up on the right, takes it across the timeline. Tries a zip a pass, batted down by Cassie Verhand, gets it back from Kavanaugh. Cassie, left of the lane, is gonna come all the way through, went for the bank, no good. Rebound is pulled down once again by Medina. Right side shot up and no good. In fact, it was blocked. Chin and Ryan unable to get it away. It goes out of bounds back to the East.
I can't ever recall doing one of these games where it's been tied this late. Usually it's a pretty good blowout one way or the other.
Yeah, but usually one team exerts their dominance at one point. Olivia Kavanaugh for three, left side, and the East reclaims the lead, 50-47. West back on the attack. It's Ryan. Passes. Left side. Start. Ooh. For three. In and out. No good. Barehand the rebound. Battles for it. Has it. Got stripped out of bounds. And we have a timeout on the floor. 8:06 to play in regulation. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. The East 50. The West 47. Jeff Terrell, Chris Collins, Dave Reno, our producer. Play back on now. 8:06 to play. The West with the lead. And a three-pointer put up. Gatsunis on the right side. She has been phenomenal tonight. I mean, really, really good. When she's been out there, that's when the West has been at their best. Shot from the left side, no good. Rebound comes down to the West. Gatsunis has it. She's out there with a couple of girls from Pioneer, Scoville, and also Brianna Yops. She misses, though, that time, but rebound taken down by Jess Scoville. Gets it back to Sophie Gatsunis. Left side pass. Jumper for three. Left side. Good. Buried. Lorraine Joensen of Northampton with that one. Right side shot up a little bit short. Tipped around. Scoville had it. Lost it out of bounds. It will stay with the East. They trail by two. 52-50 with 7:20 to play. And now the pass goes into the backcourt. It's going to be a layup for Gatsunis. Lays it up and in off the turnover. 54-50. West now by four. Their biggest lead was five early on at 7-2. They bat it down. This grouping right now has just been phenomenal. Jeskovo gets it back. Pass is tipped around, though. They nearly came up with over. Oh, they went over and back, yep. But it was actually, I thought it got tipped away, but
I
no.
I thought it did, too, but that's not what they called.
Yep, so. George Shaheen said, nope, backcourt violation. This was Caroline Merkel. So there's three Pioneer girls out there. Merkel, Yops, and Jess Scoville. Carrie. She'll drive through a little scoop shot blocked by Merkel out of bounds. It'll stay with the East. 17 to shoot. They trail by four with 6:45 to play. And waiting to hold. Throws it out deep. They finally do get it in. They kick it on the right side. Pull-up jumper from 18. He is no good. Rebound to Merkel. Outlet on the right. Running up is Briops. Sophie Gatsunis, wide open tray, in and out, no good. Rebound is pulled down. Taken across is Hope Parker. Hope, bounce pass on the right wing to Volpe. Volpe into the right corner. Shot clock down to 15, tried to feed the paint. Tipped out of bounds. That was off of the arm of Lorraine Joensen. Parker will check out. She's been replaced by Hall from East Hampton. So two East Hampton girls out there. Scoville and Merkel check out for the West All-Stars. They're, of course, from Pioneer. They inbound the ball to Hall. She loses it, though. Tried to save it on the sideline. Couldn't quite do it. Back to the West. And still more people coming in. And like you said, Chris, just about a full house here at Goodnow Gymnasium for the boys' game coming up. Although presumably some fans will be leaving after the girls' game. Gatsunis on the left wing. Throws over on the right side. Three ball put up by Bree Yops, no good. Rebound taken down by Diaz of Frontier. Left side, three ball put up and in. Nicely done again. Lorraine Joensen of Northampton.
Oh, this is the run we were talking about, 7 points.
This is their biggest lead of the game. Hall on the right side, gives up the three. She'll go baseline, blocked though by Joensen. Outlet to the left to Gatsunis, Sophie. Runs it up, goes behind the back, to the line, to the lane. Right side, Bree Yops takes it underneath, gives it up. Diaz, kick it right side, Gatsunis, fakes the three, gets it to Yops, she'll take the three, short. Battle, comes down to Bree again, puts it up, no good. And finally, here comes the East on the break, they trail by seven. Pull-up jumper in the lane is good.
That was a nice little, again, very quick.
Kayla.
57-52, that broke a long run. 5-point lead, though, for the West. Joensen, she'll take another three. She drains that one. She's on fire right now, and we have our timeout on the floor, I do believe. We're going to take the break right here.
It's a 30-second timeout.
All right, we'll take a quick 30-second timeout. Back after this on Bear Country. Julia Carey of Athol just hit for the East. West now back on the attack. Their lead down to 6. And Johansson gets it over to Ryan. Got tipped out of bounds. Ends up over to Kevin Hollister. And which way are we going? It is going to go over to the West All-Stars. And Johansson will inbound. Gets it to Ryan at the top of the key. Ryan feeds the paint to McCarthy, looking for some help. Gets her girl up in the air. Ryan gets it on the right side. Diaz, nice ball movement. Johansson for 3, hits again.
She is absolutely tearing it up.
And now we'll take another quick 30-second timeout for our presentation of the awards. Back after this on Bear Country.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we have a couple of special awards we are going to present, as we do at this time every year here at the All-Star Games. Our first is the Jack Lehman Sportsmanship Award. Jack Lehman, of course, the late great UMass basketball coach and later a broadcaster, the Sportsmanship Award named after him. And this year the members of Board 28 have decided to give it to Greenfield High School for their excellent sportsmanship and their terrific experiences at Greenfield High School throughout the year. Accepting the award, the athletic director, Mike Kucheski, boys coach, Tim Cablis, and girls JV coach, Roy Emerson. Congratulations. And our next award is the Tom Cove Award, which goes to somebody who's made a significant contribution to the game of basketball in Hampshire and Franklin counties. And this year goes to one of our own, Gary Stacy, who is a 36-year official on Board 28 and on the former Girls Board as our recipient this year. He was a mentor to many, many younger officials coming up through the ranks. Top-notch official who always had kind of an easygoing way about him. I know a favorite with a lot of coaches just because he just went out there and did his job. Gary, also a president of Board 28, a college official and a college observer for the Atlantic 10 Conference at UMass. And unfortunately, Gary, who, if you ever worked with him or knew him, would always tell you a joke and maybe actually told you one he hadn't told you before, is unable to be with us this year. He had to hang up the stripes due to some health issues, which continue to be a little bit of a problem. I know he wanted to be here. He's actually on FaceTime right now watching all this. So, Gary, we hope you're feeling better soon. We'll get you this. Congratulations, my friend.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, Chris, I don't always like technology. I think we get a little carried away with it sometime, but that is way cool that Gary was able to view this on FaceTime because he's not feeling well enough to be here tonight. That is really, really cool. And right now, Nate Burdick has his phone, and they're FaceTiming with Jerry Burgess. So you got Burgie over there. You got Artie Belanger. Bobby Betzold, again, is working the state final tomorrow. That is... That's just really great. Congratulations, Gary. Well-deserved winner of the Tom Cove Award. And welcome to the club. All right, 63-54 in favor of the West as they have taken over the game here in the second half. Olivia Cavanaugh with a 3 a little while ago. She has the ball right now. They're going to jump out on her. And coming through, Kenzie Tenney went dribbled into a triple team, and that's not usually going to work out.
No, that wasn't going to work out. She was pretty well surrounded, and we're going back the other way.
Yep, she ended up getting a held ball, and back to the West, leading by 9 with 3.5 to play. Again, we'll have a very brief post-game show, and then we'll get you set for the boys' All-Star game. Ryan in the paint, a little teardropper, went for the bank, no good. Rebound is taken down by Kenzie Tenney. Kenzie kicks it right side. Fadeaway Jay up in good, nicely done there by Michelle Zawalski. 63-56, so now they're back to within 7. Ryan in the paint, throws it over left side. Molly Duclos, line drive shot, no good, tipped around. Here comes Tenzi again. As Zawalski, same spot, back to Tenzi this time, but Molly Duclos got her arm in there and tipped it over to Lisa Portier. 2.45 2:55 to play. 7-point lead for the West. Ryan, between the circles. Cross court pass on the right. Shannon Ryan is from Smith Vocational, by the way. School we don't ordinarily cover. Pass is way too high. They're trying to get it over to Brianna Fellows of Gateway. Oh, check that. That's McCarthy, rather. Megan McCarthy from Northampton. So the East puts up a jumper from the left side. That is no good. Put back Zawacki, Zawalski hits again. Tell you, if her team wins, she's going to definitely be a candidate for the player of the game. She's been turning in a really fine effort. They're going to get Cassie Verheyen out there. And she's done some damage tonight. We're going to do a quick sub here. Not taking a full timeout here, but teams are changing up here. 2:21 to play, 63-58. West designated home team leading by five. Haley Lowell of Mohawk in a high post. Duclos got hit as she shot the ball. Got tipped out of bounds. It'll go to the West.
Yeah, no foul call.
Lowell inbound, gets it in to Gatsunis, who a good bet to get player of the game, potentially. Little pick and roll action down low. The leaner by McCarthy, no good. Saved on the baseline. And all the way through. Zawalski feeds it to Tenzi. Shot no good. Tenzi unable to get it. Nice try there, though, by Kenzie. And we're down to 1:45 to play now and a 5-point lead. A bucket here would be huge for the West. Molly Duclos sealed off on the baseline. Got it to start. Shannon start. The leaner in and out, no good. So still some life for the East. Kenzie Tenney on the left side. Cassie Verheyen pulls up from 17. Went for the bank. No good. Deep rebound. Tipped around. Zawalski hits.
Oh. Michelle Zawalski.
63-60. It's a one-possession game, mostly because of what Zawalski's been doing lately. And look out, Joensen's going to come back into the game here. Next stoppage of play. Molly Duclos gets an offensive rebound off a miss. She's double-teamed. Michelle Lay tied her up as Dick Verheyen on the arrow. It goes back to the East with a chance to tie.
Yeah, three ties it.
1:03 left. But again, for the West, one of their primary weapons, especially here in the second half, number 21, Lorraine Joensen. 1 minute left. 3-point lead for the West. East with the ball. Cassie Verheyen goes left side. Kicks it back. Top of the key. Kavanaugh. Ooh, she wanted to pull the trigger. Here comes Verheyen. Passes over. Goes off the leg. All the way back. His start goes up. High off the glass. No good. Rebound to Gatsunis now. 40 seconds to play. 22 on the shot clock. Sophie takes it out to the center court circle. Guarded by Cassie Verheyen. They go down low. Joensen goes up the left hand. No, but a foul.
Yeah, I got to think Joensen's going to be in the conversation for player of the game
has
as
well. Has
to
be, yeah.
Solid, solid performer. She really can. She's been shooting threes like crazy, and that time was a strong post move.
Yep, Gatsunis has been amazing tonight. As we mentioned, Joensen. On the other side, Michelle Zawalski's had a really fine effort.
It's almost unfair to have those two on the same, same team, much less the same line.
Free throw by Joensen's good. And Martin is out. No, Martin's going to stay. Michelle Lay will check out. Back in. Michelle Zawalski. She's going to try to get a touch here on offense. We're down to 30.4 seconds left. A 4-point lead for the West. Make it a 5-point lead. As hitting again, Joensen, the 6'2 senior. They're all seniors here. Shot clock off.
Oh,
they nearly turned it over. Cassie Barron. They can't take a lot of time. Cassie's going to take a three. Front rim, no. Gatsunis has it. 18 seconds left. They trail by five. The East team just settles in on defense. They can dribble it out here. And it looks like that's what they will do. Left side starts going to take a shot. That is no good. 6 seconds left. Put back by Joensen. No, but a foul. And with 3.8 seconds left, she will go to the line.
I think a couple free throws could ice this one up if it hasn't already been iced.
Yep. It's a two-possession game right now with only 3.8 to go. So
Lorraine Joensen shooting two.
First free throw is good. Yeah, I'm gonna say it's her.
I would think.
We'll see what the But Adam Frenier, the PA guy, says they do an MVP award for this game as well. We usually go along the line with them. Second free throw, no good. Their handle rebound, and that'll do it. Final score here. The West All-Stars 66, the East 60. And our post-game show is coming up next on Bear Country 95.3. All right, back here at Goodenough Gymnasium in South Deerfield. It's All-Star Night, the girls' game in the books. The West coming back from a 12-point deficit. They win by 6, 66-60 as we get ready for the boys' game, Chris. But first, we'll touch on the girls' game. Great performance by a lot of these girls, but none bigger than Lorraine Joensen of Northampton High. She was phenomenal.
Yeah, inside out, you know, she can shoot the ball. She shoots threes. She's a great post player. Just a fantastic performance. And 22 points to lead all scorers, so she wins it.
And she wins the Helena Chemical Player of the Game. Congratulations to her. She was very pleased to get that one. We turn our attentions now, Chris, to the boys' game. And, you know, we look at some of the local guys that we cover. You know, Tion Brown of Turner's Falls is here. A couple of Greenfield guys, Connor Joy, Kevin Mendez. We've got Torsten Sloan Anderson at 6'6". I wonder if he's going to throw one down tonight. A couple of Pioneer guys, Tucker Llewellyn, Tyler Martin. Ben Barshevsky of Frontier is one of the coaches, along with Scotty Thayer. This is going to be a great night. The boys' game is always a lot of fun.
Yeah, it always is, and it's a good chance for these guys. A lot of combinations, like we said, that don't usually play together. And how about having Sami Rowe and Tion Brown on the same team, which is good news for Tion, because Sami and he had quite a duel three times this season, including on the biggest stage of them all, the Curry-Hicks Cage. And it'll see how they do. If they get on the same line, that'll be even more interesting.
And, of course, I know that for Sami Rowe and for anybody else that maybe wanted to be playing in a state final game tomorrow, you play the state final game. You have nothing to do with the All-Star game. But, hey, this is quite a quote-unquote consolation prize. You can come play the All-Star game here at Goodenough Gymnasium. Big crowd on hand. We're expecting a very entertaining boys matchup again. The girls. Final in the book, and the West over the East by a final score of 66-60. We'll take a timeout, and we will set the scene for the boys' game coming up next on Bear Country 95.3.